Guten Morgen, alle Guten. Ich bin dann der Prof von Luxemburgisch with Anne. And here is your weekly lesson. Heißt den Wochenlektion. In this lesson, I will briefly explain what a modal verb is. I will talk about how we use a modal verb in Luxemburgisch. And I will introduce you to 3 out of 6 modal verbs. Was du bereit? Are you ready? Dann los! So, what is a modal verb? Well, modal verbs give us the ability to speak about another verb in a way that shows a relationship. For example, if I say, ich kann tanzen, I use the verb können, which means to can, and this implies an ability. But what if I use ich will tanzen? So here I say I want to dance, and wanting something is different from being able to. Okay, and that's the magic of a modal verb. So modal verbs give us the ability to speak about an action. How do we use a modal verb in Luxembourgish? Well, modal verbs function like helping verbs, just like sind, to be, or hun, to have, because they work together, but not always in Luxembourgish, in connection with another verb. We place the modal verb in the second position of the sentence and conjugate it according to the subject. And if there is another verb attached to the modal, we place this other verb at the infinitive form at the very end of the sentence. For example, ich will oder ich muss an die Bäckerei gehen. So this is, I must go to the bakery. And literally this would be, I must to the bakery go. So you see in Luxembourgish the second verb comes at the infinitive at the very end of the sentence. And I wanted to add a brief note about this small word, z, before I enter into the lesson. So phrases like in order to buy milk in English or in order to speak Luxembourgish translate into Luxembourgish using this small word z. For example, to buy milk is in Luxembourgish 4 Müllers zu kaufen. To speak Luxembourgish 4 Lützebisch zu schwätzen. Okay, but modal verbs do not require this word zu. So this is an important fact to remember when you build phrases with the modal verbs. Now let's continue with the lesson. Luxembourgish modal verbs. Luxembourgish has 6 modal verbs. We have dürfen, to be allowed to, können, to be able to, wollen, to want, sollen, to should or ought to, müssen, to must, and werden, will. Now, you can learn in another lesson, introduction to the Luxembourgish verbs, the conjugation of all these modal verbs. I have put the link under this video. In this lesson, we will concentrate on 3 modal verbs, können, müssen and werden. Don't forget that you can read the full transcript of this lesson on my blog luxembourgischwithanne.lu/blog. Let's start with können. Pronounce it können, to can. So, used as the more colloquial term for an ability, können means to be able to or to can. Beispiele, examples. Hat kann mich nicht verstehen. Hat kann mich nicht verstehen. She can't understand me. Now, literally, this would be she can me not understand. But remember that if you use a modal verb, the second verb has to go at the very end of the sentence at the infinitive. Let's see another example. Wir können ein bisschen Lützebäuerisch schwätzen. Wir können ein bisschen Lützebäuerisch schwätzen. We can speak a little bit of Luxembourgish. Literally, we can a little bit Luxembourgish speak. And the last example. Meng Mam kant kanna ofuelen. Meng Mam kant kanna ofuelen. My mom can pick up the children. Let's move on with müssen. Now, if there's one thing you learn as you grow up, is that there are things you are permitted to do, things you should do, things you want to do, and of course, things you must do. And for all those musts, use müssen in Luxembourgish. Beispiele, examples. The Puppelsche kreischt, hier muss hungrig sein. The Puppelsche kreischt, hier muss hungrig sein. The baby's crying, he must be hungry. Oh. Hat muss de Bus verpasst hun, sos wir hat schon hei. Hat muss de Bus verpasst hun, sos wir hat schon hei. She must have missed the bus, otherwise she would be already here. And the last example. Mir hu kein Müllisch mei, mir müssen unbedingt a Kaffe goen. Mir hu kein Müllisch mei, mir müssen unbedingt a Kaffe goen. We don't have any milk left. We absolutely have to go shopping. Now, we use as well müssen in the sense of should in English to say that something is likely or probable. We are not 100% certain, but we believe it to be true. Let's have some examples. Sie sind für ein enger Stunde gang, Sie müssen allo daheim sein. Sie sind für ein enger Stunde gang, Sie müssen allo daheim sein. So they left an hour ago, they should be here by now. You see, so we are not 100% certain, but we believe it. Another example. Meng Mama ist kurz einkaufen gegangen, sie muss aller Block heimkommen. Meng Mama ist kurz einkaufen gegangen, sie muss aller Block heimkommen. This means, my mother went briefly shopping, she should be back home every moment. And let's have a look at the last modal verb for today, werten. Pronounce it werten. This is most of the time translated into will in English. But this verb is very special as it has many important uses in Luxembourgish. Here are the two most important uses of werten. The first one. So to express a certainty about the future or an assertion, use werten plus the infinitive form of a verb. Examples, Beispiele. Am August werde ich a Schottland an Vakanz gehen. Am August werde ich a Schottland an Vakanz gehen. This means, in August I will go to Scotland for a vacation. And you see, we have the second verb at the infinitive form at the very end of the sentence. Another example. D'Wieder wird sich bestimmt ändern. D'Wieder wird sich bestimmt ändern. The weather is definitely going to change. So here it is a certainty about the future. And now let's have a look at an assertion. Hat Wert sicher krank sein? Hat Wert sicher krank sein? She is surely sick. Let's have a look at the second most important use of werten. This is to talk about probabilities, hopes or fears. Examples. Beispiele. Hier wird daheim sein. Hier wird daheim sein. He will probably be at home. So you see, this is a probability. Hier wird daheim sein. Another example. Meng Mam wird jo nicht krank gehen. Meng Mam wird jo nicht krank gehen. I hope my mother will not get sick. So here it is a hope. I hope my mother will not get sick. And let's have a last example in the sense of a fear, to express a fear. Et wird jo nicht weh tun, oder? Et wird jo nicht weh tun, oder? It will not be painful, or? This is a question you can maybe ask a doctor or when you are at hospital, for example. Great! Don't forget that you can read the full transcript of today's lesson on my blog, luxembourgishwithanne.lu/blog, and on my blog you can as well find Luxembourgish idioms that use modal verbs. Now, learning and memorizing such sentences will help you to sound more like a native speaker. I hope that this lesson was helpful, and don't forget that you can as well learn Luxembourgish from scratch with my Luxembourg online course Easy Luxembourgish Level 1. And if you intend to take the Sprachentest in the upcoming future, please note that I have as well created an online course to take successfully the Sprachentest. I have put the link under this video. Merci für Nachgucken und bis nächste Woche. Thank you for watching and see you next week.